Good morning, Raiders. I'm Rachel Smallwood.
And I'm Paloma de la Paz.
Today, we take a look at what the Environmental Club has been up to for Earth Week and what we all can do for Earth through the Earth every day.
We preview next week's choir and instrumental concerts.
And look at an amazing visit from Missy Franklin in pictures.
All that and more this week on
RJTV. Monday, and all week this week was Earth Week.
Yesterday, the Environmental Club met early in the morning for road cleanup. RJTV reporters Hannah Wright and Anna Grande were there.
Yesterday, the Environmental Club gathered for a road cleanup in honor of Earth Week.
And I was like really excited about Earth Day.
Teachers and students took Lewiston Way to pick up trash. It's one of many opportunities the Environmental Club offers throughout the year to care for our common home.
This is Anna and Hannah for RJTV.
Thanks, Hannah and Anna. Let's make sure we take good care of our campus and always be mindful of how we can help the Earth by recycling, composting, and what else?
Carpooling.
Yeah, that's a good one. Throughout the week, the Environmental Club has shared some interesting data on the Vivi screens and on Instagram.
Did you know that our cafeterias produce 116 pounds of waste every day? That's 20,880 pounds per year.
Plus, did you know that Colorado uses about 5.34 million acre-feet of water per year?
Now let's throw it over to Anna Karen Palacios de Castro and Jordan Fulcher with a preview of next week's concerts.
Thanks, Paloma and Rachel.
Just when you thought the performances on the stage and the Z-Theater were done for the year, things are heating up.
Next Tuesday is the Spring Instrumental Concert, and Thursday is the Spring Choir Concert. Gigi Gibson, Cami Gray, and I visit the instrumental and choir classes to get a preview of next week's concerts.
1, 2.
The spring choir concert, the fun part is we tend to go a little bit more pop, Broadway, rock. It's also a really fun time to celebrate our seniors.
We have an amazing soloist, Abby Kennedy.
It's a lot of like teamwork and team effort and chemistry that goes into our performance.
It's going to be awesome. The music, there's a wide variety of music between our jazz band playing, the concert band, the string orchestra, and the full orchestra.
A lot of practicing solos, make sure we have the right tempo.
Kind of let loose more in the spring than in the winter.
Everyone's worked so hard this semester, so I feel like we really would like to come.
There's something for everyone. It's a wide variety of music, and our students have been working really hard, and they are just really eager to share it with anybody that wants to come.
It's a really fun way to celebrate the end of the year, and it's in the Z Theater.
Thanks, ladies. I'm looking forward to those concerts. And don't forget about the student-directed play, The Cardstell, which will show for 2 nights, May 10th and May 11th.
We'll be back next week with another Raiders sports update.
Yes, your spring sports teams are gearing up for the postseason.
There was one major announcement this week in the world of sports. Flag football is now officially a CHASA sport.
Flag football will become the 33rd sport sanctioned by CHASA and the 18th sanctioned sport for girls in Colorado.
The flag football team is open to all grade levels and is always looking for new members. Check your announcements for more details or follow the team on Instagram.
And our big splash from the sports world was yesterday's visit from 2013 grad and 5-time Olympic gold medalist Missy Franklin.
She spent time with the swim teams in the bubble for dedication of the pool in her name and spoke with the whole school in a special assembly. It was so inspiring. Thank you to Missy for coming back to campus and being such a role model for our current and future Raiders.
Now back to you, Rachel and Paloma.
Thanks, Anna Karen and Jordan. The visit from Missy was another great way to celebrate the 20-year anniversary of the Girls Division.
And today is the last installment of the Wisdom of Women speaker series. Join us in Madge's Hall at lunch on the Learning Steps for a talk from retired Air Force Colonel Tracy LaTourette.
That is going to be really cool. Finally, today on RJTV, we leave you with a promo.
Okay, my favorite book would be Book Thief by Marcus Zizek.
Gone Girl.
My favorite book is One Fish, Two Fish, Red Fish, Blue Fish.
My favorite book is All the Light We Cannot See.
Have a great weekend, Raiders, and see you next week.